You know, it's interesting though, during that period when you're competing in IndyCar, Formula One, traveling all around the world constantly, you've said those were not your fondest years. It really put a tremendous burden on you, in fact. Explain why.
Well, you know, I always said that to achieve something that's worthwhile, there's some sacrifice involved, always. I mean, of sacrifice with me, was a lot of it was maybe I wasn't sacrificing as much as the family, pretty much, because, you know, my kids reminded me so many times, Dad, you know, Barbie says, you weren't even my graduation. You know, I wasn't at too many birthdays either, you know. So it, on the family side, luckily, I had, you know, a wonderful lady, my wife, Deanne. She just kept everything together, you know. So, but she was the one who was sacrificing because, again, you know, there were no picnics every weekend somewhere. You know, when people relaxed and spent time with the family, I was working. And so if you want to call sacrifice, that I think it would be it. The travel, yes, I mean, you know, it's never fun because, but I had it so well oiled in that area. I had my own airplane, and you know, even one, it was back in the late 70s, in 1 year, I did 24 crossings with the Concorde alone.
I read your book and thought it was great, and in your wife, there was a quote from your wife in the book that I thought was really interesting, and you and your wife, obviously, as you mentioned, been married more than 50 years, but this was after your Indy 500 win and the subsequent fame that that brought. She said in the book, quote, "That was the most difficult time that I remember over his whole career because we just got inundated with requests for interviews and appearances. That's when I finally realized I didn't have a husband anymore. He belonged to the public. That hurt, and it took a lot for me to accept it. But eventually, if you're going to stay with the marriage, you have to accept it." Your reaction when you read that for the first time?
Well, Deanne is very direct and very honest in every way, to a fault. And you know, she just says it like it is. But at the same time, she was my rock. She was solid as could be. And I don't think I, quite honestly, the more than I even sort of reassess the situation as life goes on, she was so much more important than I ever gave her credit for, because I needed to have my mind serene. I could not perform properly and, you know, under, you know, situations where, you know, you're, there's always the concentration, everything is so intense, you know, because it's dangerous on top of everything else otherwise. And because of the way that she treated me and the way she handled the situation, it just, I was clear. I was just, you know, relaxed sort of thing, and which was really a total benefit for me. It was a selfish thing, really. And she did that for me, and I can, again, I can realize what she was going through, because the more demands, the less time that I would spend with them, and the more that she had just to do it alone, you know. So again, it always takes a team to really accomplish certain things, and she was really the best teammate that I could have possibly had.
How challenging is that when you're at the height of your career, traveling all over the world for your professional pursuits, to then still, you know, maintain a strong family and have success in that arena as well?
Well, that was the whole trick, you know, and family was always, you know, paramount, always very important to me. But as you can see, I was, again, fortunate enough that, you know, with everything that I was doing, I could afford certain luxuries, if you will, such as, you know, very early on in my career, at the end of the 60s, bought my first airplane, and I had airplanes throughout my career whereby, and that what facilitated the movement of my family everywhere, where, you know, I could load family and some friends, load them up and go.